Now what we do is that. Now what are you seeing in the screen? NCO5 session 1 to 6 edition. Is it visible to you though? The slides, sir, the presentation NCO5
yes,
session.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Right. Yes, sir. Thanks for confirmation. Thanks a lot. So NCO5, okay, session 1 by 6. So why are we taking the next 6 classes? Do you? So you need 1 that covers accounting overview, and unit 2 cost concepts, and unit 3 financial statements. So just one thing here, key accounting overview, the unit 1 accounting overview, and let me take my pen, that will be here. So the accounting overview and the financial statements, these are related subjects. So first of all, we will cover the accounting overview, then the financial statement, then unit 2 is based on the cost concepts. So this is we will cover last, because cost concept, that means this is based on the cost accounting and all these things, so it will be covered later. So let's unit 1, get the, let me check my pen. Yes, we need an accounting overview. What we'll get in this introduction, needs of accounting, objectives of the accounting, branches of the accounting, accounting process, accounting equations, and accounting concepts. So first of all, accounting and introduction. Asset and the profits, accounting, first of all, this is the master degree, hope you have already studied your bachelor degree, key accounting. Based on recording, classification, summarization of the data, day-to-day transactions, and finally we interpret the results there. So in short, we'll be studying here the accounting, that means financial accounting, which ascertains the profit and loss and the financial position of the business for a given period. Okay. What is the need for accounting? Accounting chahiye generally kyun chahiye? First of all, accounting, you have a large business. You have a large business. Now, lakhs of, you can say the lakhs of transactions are there. It's very much practically impossible to record them haphazardly, and to summarize all the content. That's why we need a systematic
Excuse me, sir. You are not audible.
Okay. So you need the systematic. My pen was not working on that side. You need a systematic study, systematic method, systematic equipment for recording, for analyzing, for interpreting your transactions. That's why I'm visible though. I was not audible, but I'm visible though. Let me confirm one. Okay. Now suppose there is a big bazaar. Okay, big bazaar. Thousands and lakhs of transactions happen in a single day. So it's very much impractical to record and to classify, to summarize these transactions. So accounting is such an equipment. Accounting, basically the financial accounting, is such an equipment which gives you the tools, techniques, methodologies for recording also, and for summarizing the results also. That's why accounting is needed. For financial data also, for getting the results also. Definition of accounting. One definition I would like to share here. This definition given by Committee for Terminology of American Institute Certified Public Accountants, AICPA. Okay, that means this is the chartered accountancy course of the American. What was stated there? Accounting is the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing in a significant manner the terms of money transactions, which are in part or least of the financial character, interpreting the results thereof. First of all, that means this is a very good and powerful definition. So, in the examination, you may write this thing also. Now, accounting is the art of recording. Obviously, because accounting, you know, this based on the custom traditions. The accounting records the transactions and it's as the art of recording, classifying. That means you have to group, you have to classify, you have to make the divisions of the various types of accounts and summarizing. Finally, when you leave the results, you have to summarize the data. So, yes, first you have to record all the transactions. Now, all transactions, that means this includes revenue also, this includes expenses also, this includes asset also, liabilities also. So, how you will calculate the account of a particular account? How you will calculate, how you will be accounting for a particular classification? That's why number two, you have to make classification. You have to make classification. Then I need to change the color. Okay. Not a visible actually. Number three, you have to summarize them. You have to summarize them. Why summarization is needed? Because so many types of classifications are there. Assets also there, liabilities also there, revenues also there. Okay. Finally, you have to summarize. So some students may belong to the other background. That's why I'm telling this. Next to it, you have to finalize all these things. Finalize to the final accounts as you. Now these are the four processes, and in a significant manner, and the transaction which can be converted in the terms of money and be can be recorded in the part of this financial character interpreting the results. That means the monetary transactions, not the qualitative transactions, we will record and finalize, and finally we have to interpret, and the final thing is we have to present the data. We have to present the data. This is the thing. Data presentation is more important. As accounting finalizes the records, but data presentation is more relevant. Because shareholders are there, investors are there, bankers are there, government are there. Objectives of the accounting, sorry. Objectives of the accounting. Accounting is here. This is one of your important questions. Excuse me. I'm audible. Hello, audience. I'm audible.
Yes, sir. Now you are audible.
just I got a technical issue. No problem. My mic was just connected. Like, listen. So, objective of the accounting. Now, number one is to keep systematic records of the business. That means you are doing a business, you are handling a large business. So many transactions, hundreds of transactions you will face on a single day. You can't record all these transactions haphazardly. That's why you must have a tool, a powerful tool and technique to record.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Can you speak little slowly, please?
Okay. My presentation is visible. You may keep on the mic. Okay. Just a single participant may keep on the mic. My presentation is visible. Just confirm.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. It
will be. To keep the systematic records of the business. Actually, I'm happy to teach the students now. But that's it. Next, we need to ascertain profit and loss of the business. So, accounting's first job is to record. First job is to record. Second job to ascertain the profit or loss of the business. Ultimate objective of any type of counting or accounting is to ascertain the result. So here means business results kya ho sakte hai? Profit and loss, that's it. To ascertain the profit and loss of the business. Next, to ascertain the financial position of the business. These are two things. So you need the profit and loss also. You need the financial position of the business also. So in common language, I would like to explain what these things. Common students obviously know these things, no problem at all. Profit and loss of your shop. One, suppose profit and loss of your shop. That means nowadays, for a period, for this year, for this month, for this month, what is your profitability? What is your profitability? How you were earning? What is your profit trend? This is what called the profitability position or profit or loss for a certain period. आपको कैसे profit हो रहा है? Number two, financial position. Financial position of your shop. Suppose you have a garment shop. Now financial position of your shop means not the profitability of this period, but the permanent profitability from the beginning to current day. What is your financial position means? How many assets are, how many liabilities have you till date? How much capital you have invested? How much investment you have paid? So current scenario, current date, what is the position of your assets and liabilities? And solvency, you can say the position of the solvency. This is what called the technical meaning of the financial position. Profits of आजकल कैसे हो रहे हैं? That is profitability position. आपकी financial position, solvency कैसे? आपकी संपत्ति और liability कैसे? This is what called the financial positions. Okay. Next week, to provide accounting information to the interested parties. To the interested parties. How many participants are there? Direct and indirect participants are there. They need to keep interest on your business. That one we'll discuss also. Bank also, government also, our shareholders also, our managers also. They need the financial information. Now it's our responsibility as the account keeper. Okay. As the accounts manager, as the finance manager, this is our responsibility to disclose the financial data to the needed parties. This is the thing. So providing information. From the very beginning, clear statement is that record keeping, profit loss ascertain karna, financial position kya hai wo batana, and finally ye sare calculation aap karke, you have to disclose to the interested parties also. So here only your responsibility goes to an end. Now, parties interested in accounting information. Which are the various parties? They involve directly or indirectly with their business. Number one, owners and shareholders. Owners ko accounting information kyun chahiye? Because owners establishes the business. Owners keeps, owners, suppose this is sole proprietorship business owner. If a partnership business, that is partner. Okay. If that is a company, shareholders, these are the owners. Kyunki wo invest kiye hai, they will keep interest on your business to know the financial position, the profitability position. Sabse pehle to owner ko hi chahiye. Prospective investors, here not the investors, prospective investors. People also, people might be interested to invest in your company. They are called the prospective investors. Now, if we will show them the financial position and the profitability position, the financial statements of our company, so they might be interested to invest in our company. That's why they need the data. So, yahan par hum kya padh rahe hain? Which are the various parties who might have interest to know the financial data of our business? Business may be sole proprietorship business, may be company. Moreover, we will discuss from the company's point of view. Company's also a business. lenders also need the accounting information. Why? Because lender lent us lakhs of rupees, crores of rupees. That's why they need to monitor our financial data. Creditors also, managers, because managers are the authorities to whom we should report. So they are the reporting authority. That's why financial information should be reported. Government, because government levy taxes. That's why government needs this much of information. Employees. There is one aspect, government levy taxes. That's why government needs the accounting information, because tax is based on income, and income is based on income statements. Income statements. So if we will not disclose the income statement, how government will assure that you are giving the correct tax? That's why government also interested in our business. Employees get the remuneration, employees get the benefit, employees get the compensation, and ultimately employees are our manpower, our assets, with the sacrifice of whom, for the devotion of whom the company get developed. That's why they must interest. Abhi to RTI Act ke hisab se aapko sab kuch dikhana hi padega. The employees have also interest in our financial process. Researchers. Suppose you are a PhD scholar, you want to research on a particular aspect, some financial aspect. So you need data, financial data from the company. That's why researchers here means the PhD scholars, or any independent researchers, or the professors, or United Nations delegates. They need our financial data for the research purpose. And finally, citizen. This is the world in 21st century. Everything is transparent. Citizens are the subscriber of your company. Citizens are the well-wisher of your company. They are the purchaser of your product. That's why they have also interest to watch your financial position, whether you are doing the good practice or not. Sorry for interruption. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
I got a call. Which are the various branches? Literally, there are 10 branches of accounting. But by watching your curriculum, I have prepared this thing. One is financial accounting, another is cost accounting, another is management accounting. So my ink is not visible here. Financial accounting. Financial accounting that starts from recording of transactions and with interpreting the results. Interpreting the results. This much accounting. Business already set up. You are doing business. Selling process is going on. Now, you are earning revenue. So, transactions, recording, final result, be part of financial accounting. Before that, cost accounting. And after that, management accounting. So, these three are interrelated. First of all, financial accounting. It records simply the information. First of all, information here means the transactions which can be converted to monetary terms. Monetary terms, transactions can only be recorded in the accounting, not the social terms, not the qualitative transactions. Next to it, managerial decision making. Accounting provides such a platform, such information which helps the managers, which helps the managerial body for managerial decision making. For example, if we can state them ki our product A, suppose our product A means the blazer. Okay, we are using the blazers. Suit and blazers department gives us highest profit, then manager may keep interest to expand such product or such department. That's why managerial decision depends upon the accounting reports. Interpreting financial information. Interpreting means, the English terminology interpreting means, simply means finalizing and finding out the results. आप कुछ और पढ़े होंगे, excuse for that, but this is the thing. Interpreting means finalizing and finding out the records. Generally, calculation वाला records. उसको कहते हैं interpreting, financial information. Communicating the results. You have prepared the financial statements. You know that what is the financial position, what is the profitability position of the business. If you not disclose them to the managers, to the shareholders, to the parties, how it can be communicated, how it can be generalized. That's why from recording, then interpreting, then communicating the results. यहाँ पर खत्म होता है. Cost accounting ये क्या चीज़ है? Cost accounting simply means accounting for the cost. Cost participle, cost particles, cost center. Cost accounting generally it's done from recording the cost data. Recording the cost data. We'll keep writing some notes that will be beneficial to you because these are only the highlights. Okay. Recording the cost data. Next is to calculate the cost of the product or cost center, and it also helps in cost control. It also helps in cost control. Cost accounting simply means cost data record karo, then cost center ya fir product ki cost calculation karo, total cost as well as unit cost, then cost control karo. Because koi bhi ek accounting hai uska kuch objectives bhi rehna chahiye. Simply we calculate the cost of a mobile, cost of a mobile phone. It cost rupees suppose 20,000. By analyzing all these things data, by analyzing the cost elements, etc. But we just failed to minimize the cost of that mobile. Then what is the use of this cost accounting? That's why cost accounting and some cost control. It also suggests the managers to control the cost. Cost accounting क्या होता है? Cost accounting enables the management to ascertain the cost of a product. Maybe product का cost हो सकता है, job हो सकता है, contract हो सकता है, service or unit of the production. So first and foremost objective of the cost accounting is to calculate the cost, is to ascertain the cost of a product or job or contract or service. It helps in price fixation or quotation. Okay, that means the finally at which price a phone will be sold, that will be disclosed by the cost accounting and quotation. When I approach to electronic shop, I will acquire 30 or 40 pieces of the IC. It delivers a quotation. The process of preparing such quotation is known as cost accounting. Very much simple. Because it assembles so many elements, it charges the service charge and finally discloses that this much of amount will be paid for this much of air conditioner installed. It provides information for the preparation of estimates and tenders. That means it provides the raw material, inputs and information for estimation and tenders, which are similar points. That means suppose you have to give an estimation of a project, accounting, cost accounting helps in this process. It shares some information, it collects, it gathers various cost data, which helps us estimation and tender. It helps minimizing the cost of manufacture. This is what called the ultimate object, the ultimate objective of the cost accounting. It helps in minimizing the cost of manufacture. That means not only ascertain the cost of a product.
Sir, it helps in minimizing
the cost of product actually. The cost of manufacturing actually, not manufacturing. Yes, you are correct. You are watching this presentation also, na? Hello?
Yes, actually I'm taking from mobile, so it's very like it's visible in a very small
screen. Achha, understood. You can take the screenshot also, not an issue. Okay. And later
can
on
you
can
sir, make... can you please share these PPTs?
So you have to contact me personally, okay?
Let okay, me. Sir.
Now, finally, you will get the email ID and phone number of mine, or you can contact to the assistant register to get my contact. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Next, it. Now, it helps in determining profitability of each product, process, and department. So, profitability. Product, process, or department. Product means, suppose a single mouse, this is a product. Process means, suppose in case of chemical industry, the chemical industry first we input the raw material, then we will add so many chemicals into that, then finally we will get byproducts, joint products out of that. So suppose one process number two. Now, process number two का cost क्या होगा? Department, what means department? Suppose Reliance Smart. Okay, Reliance, nowadays you can find Reliance Smart. There's vegetable departments also there. Kitchenware department also there. Okay, house, the equipments are also there. Furniture are also there, so many things. So, electrical equipments, vegetable departments, etc. All the different segments are called the department. So, a department ki cost, a process ki cost, a product ki cost. Individually, it discloses the profitability of each type of product cost and department. It is a useful tool for managerial control, help in cost reduction and cost control. This is the thing, cost reduction and cost control. You have two options. So, I am stating here. You have two options for maximizing your profit. Sorry. You have two options to maximize your profits. Either hike the sale price or else reduce the cost. Am I correct? So to enhance the scale of the economy of scale of profits, either you can hike the sale price or else you can reduce the cost. In this competitive market, you can't enhance the sale price. You can't increase the sale price of a particular product. That's why ultimately you have to reduce the cost to gain the maximum profits. Suppose the mobile phone cost rupees, actually it cost rupees. Mobile phone cost rupees 30,000. So you can't increase the sale price to 35,000 to gain the profit. Else, you can reduce the cost by planning, organizing, by reducing the price of the raw material, etc. You can reduce the price, sorry, reduce the cost of this mobile phone to 25,000 and sell it at a price of 30,000, whereby you can gain the profit of 5,000. So cost reduction and cost control is the ultimate necessary in this competitive market. So, cost control and cost reduction are the tool of cost accounting. Next, it increases the efficiency and reduces wastages and cost. तो वेस्टेज ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल एंड वेस्टेज ऑफ पावर अननेसेसरी कॉस्ट इट इंक्रीज द एफिशिएंसी दैट मींस द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन प्रोडक्टिविटी एंड रिड्यूसेस द वेस्टेज ऑफ द मटेरियल्स एंड कॉस्ट रिड्यूसेस कॉस्ट मींस कॉस्ट कंट्रोल ऑलरेडी कवर्ड इट प्रोवाइड्स कॉस्ट डेटा फॉर कंपैरिजन ऑफ डिफरेंट पीरियड्स दिस द थिंग The same product available in the year 2019 at rupees 20 and 2020 at rupees 30 due to the cost consideration. Because company also incurs more cost on these products. That's why company keep enhancing the price of the product. Cost accounting simply provides such data. Provide a platform for comparison in the year 2019 and in the year 2020. Which are the main lacunas, regions, which are the main things for we have to enhance the price of that particular product. Understand the points? So, due to the comparison prospects, cost accounting provides data. For comparison across different year, different time periods. Management accounting, just one thing. Financial accounting, when you are ready to sell the goods, you are selling the products. Financial accounting simply records your financial transactions and finally disclose the profit and loss. This is the financial accounting. But before selling the goods, you had made the products. For that also, so many transactions are required. Cost accounting records all such transactions. Manufacturer से पहले cost accounting भी आ जाता है. Understand the point? Simultaneously these are work, but still cost accounting उससे पहले भी आता है. Gathering the cost and all these things and know the disclose the total cost. Cost accounting only disclose the total cost of this mobile phone. Responsible for the cost reduction. Financial accounting, simply the selling prospects and all these things, records the data and finally know the profit and loss. Next, this is the first process you can say. This is the second accounting you can say. This is the final accounting step you can say. What is management accounting? Management accounting is depends upon the cost accounting and the financial accounting. By watching the data of financial accounting and cost accounting, we have less time to discuss. I'm speeding up the things. First process and the second cost accounting and financial accounting ko watch karte management accounting decision leta hai. Management accounting simply means accounting for the management, accounting for managerial decision making. Management accounting provides such types of information statements which enables the management to take the managerial decision. यहाँ पे आप ये जो छोटे छोटे चीज जो बुक में इतना इंची लैंग्वेज में नहीं है आप नोट करते तो आपके लिए अच्छा होता और एल्स यू कैन रिकॉर्ड द एंटायर सिस्टम तो मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग इट प्रोवाइड्स अ वे टू कम्युनिकेट एक्सपेक्ट कम्युनिकेट to manager throughout the organization. That means managers ki expectation ke hisab se communicate kiye jate hain. So management accounting do this case. Provides feedbacks which enables the manager to monitor the day-to-day operation of the company. So management accounting provides such information, feedbacks, such control equipments. It discloses the problems, the loopholes, the lacunas in financial prospects which enables the manager to monitor day-to-day operation of the company. Structures different significantly from targets results. The manager is alerted, can look cause for deviation and can correct action. Same thing as we know. Okay. That means management accounting discloses the current scenario. It discloses us the problems, the loopholes which can be monitored by the company, which can be monitored by the managers, and actual performance can be compared with the standard or past performance, and if any variation arises, that can be corrected, that can be minimized, that can be avoided. It provides a set of prescribed tools and techniques for use in decision making. Management accounting has so many equipments, study equipments like comparison statements, etc. We'll be discussing later in this subject also. Ratio analysis, so many equipments are there which use in decision making. That means management accounting has separate types of study equipments, tools which enables the manager to study and take the good action. Financial accounting process, यहाँ पर क्या था, देखिए फाइनल विच आर द ब्रांचेस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. सो तीन ब्रांचेस, फाइनेंशियल, कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग. नाउ जस्ट कम टू द फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग, फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग प्रोसेस. नंबर वन, रिकॉर्डिंग द ट्रांजैक्शंस थ्रू, डायरेक्टली बात करते हैं, जर्नल एंड सब्सिडरी बुक्स. जर्नल सब्सिडरी बुक्स के थ्रू रिकॉर्ड करता है. Classifying the transactions through ledgers. Non-commerce background students जो हैं लिख लीजिए. Summarizing the transactions. First you have to, as from the very beginning as I have started, first you have to record the transaction, all the financial transactions. Then जो financial transactions बहुत तरह के हो सकते हैं. So many types of accounts, so many types of transactions are there. That's why you have to classify the transactions. Next to it, through the ledgers. Next to it, summarize the transactions through the trial balance, through the trial balance, and interpret the ledgers. That means finally the ultimate objective of the financial accounting is to interpret the ledgers through final accounts. So final accounts के जरिए आपको इंटरप्रेट करने. So this is the whole accounting, financial accounting process. So many processes are there, but in your chapter syllabus, this must tell. Now to accounting equation. यहीं पर हम आपको कुछ बताएंगे. Accounting equation. This is based on the dual concept of the accounting. The debit and credit concept we'll discuss later. Debit and credit concept of the account. कोई भी business पे, कोई भी व्यापार पे, total assets is always equal to the total liabilities. Always. This strange, very much strange, astonishing, but this is the fact. Total assets is equal to total liabilities. Now total liabilities means capital plus liabilities, always, at any point of time. Suppose at any point of time, this is 19th June 2020. Your total asset will be the total liability, always. Suppose we jump to the 19th June 2021. At that point also, you will look back to your business, analyze your business. Then will also total assets will be equal to the total liability. Hamesha, hamesha ye rahegi. Now total liability means capital plus the liabilities. Implies that your fixed asset plus current asset equal to, this will be discussed later. Not take an example, I'm saying. Mr. X started business with rupees 1 lakh cash. Okay. As you know, these are two things. First of all, cash, and as you started it, you have also invested capital. Okay. So you have two things. Number one is assets. Here I'm writing assets. Here I'm writing liabilities. Liability. So Mr. X started business with rupees 1 lakh cash. Now, cash is the asset and you have 1 lakh cash. Very good. Now you have started business with the capital at the same time. Capital is the liability, कैपिटल भी तो एक लाख का है, कैपिटल लाइबिलिटी क्यों है फ्रॉम द बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, फ्रॉम द बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू मिस्टर एक्स इज ए थर्ड पार्टी, मिस्टर एक्स ऑनर इज ए थर्ड पार्टी बिकॉज दिस इज द बिजनेस, दिस इज द मिस्टर एक्स, मिस्टर एक्स, मिस्टर एक्स इन्वेस्टेड मनी इन द बिजनेस, नाउ बिजनेस इज ए इंडिपेंडेंट, ठीक है, फ्रॉम द बिजनेस बैकग्राउंड दे नो दैट बिजनेस हैज द इंडिपेंडेंट आइडेंटिटी फ्रॉम एनी सोर्सेस, कैश कम्स इन टू द बिजनेस दैट इज नोन एज द लाइबिलिटी टू एनी सोर्सेस बिजनेस इफ पेड कैश दैट इज नोन एज द एसेट्स, एनी एडवांस पेड बाय द बिजनेस इज नोन एज द एसेट्स. तो फ्रॉम द बिजनेस पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दिस कैपिटल इज द लाइबिलिटी, अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट नाउ, बिकॉज फ्रॉम एन एक्सटर्नल सोर्सेस इट गॉट द मनी. तो कैपिटल आपके बिजनेस में 1 लाख इन्वेस्टमेंट, और भी क्यों इसे लाइबिलिटी कहते हैं, बिकॉज वांटिंग यू हैव टू ट्रैश आउट फ्रॉम द बिजनेस 1 लाख रुपीज, ना यू हैव इन्वेस्टेड 1 लाख रुपीज टू योर बिजनेस, दैट्स व्हाई देयर विल बी अ डे व्हेन यू हैव टू रिकवर योर इन्वेस्टमेंट्स फ्रॉम द बिजनेस, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज लाइबिलिटी. तो आपके पास कैश है 1 लाख, तो आपका कैपिटल भी हुआ 1 लाख, जो कि लाइबिलिटी. नेक्स्ट वीक नाउ लुक एट हियर, एसेट इक्वल टू लाइबिलिटी 1 लाख. The business purchased furniture worth ₹15,000 and paid cash. The second date में क्या हुआ? This is the first date. This is second date. Second date में क्या हुआ? 15,000 furniture आप खरीदे, cash payment हो गया. Look at. Now cash balance आपकी कितना होगा? -15,000. क्योंकि आप पैसा दे. So you left with 85,000. Understand the point? ये आपकी cash balance कम होगी. At the same time. You purchased furniture, ना? You purchased furniture. तो cash कम हो जाने से क्या हुआ? आपकी फर्नीचर भी तो आ गया. There is no space. तो furniture 15,000 तो आ गया. तो 85,000, 15,000, this again comes to 1 lakh. Again, 1 lakh asset equal to 1 lakh liability. तो at any point of time, cash चला गया तो फर्नीचर आ गया ना भाई, एक के बदले कुछ पाने के लिए कुछ करना पड़ता है, बात सिंपल. तो अगेन एसेट इक्वल टू लायबिलिटी 1 लाख इक्वल टू 1, दिस इज द अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन. ओके, नाउ द अकाउंटिंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स, दिस इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट, यू कैन से I'm returning, just changing the ink. Accounting concepts, a most questions. Sometimes I also, first I also suggest the questions. So write down your most expected questions to be examined. Question number 1, branches of accounting. This is most expected question. Question number 2, uses of accounting. Write down. First one is branches of accounting, most expected examined question, users of accounting. Question number 3, accounting concepts. Accounting concepts. People not find accounting.
Sir, second yes. question is what?
Yes, write down. First one is branches of accounting.
Yes.
Second one is users of accounting. Users of accounting.
Yes, sir.
Third one is accounting concepts.
Okay.
चलो टिल डिस्कस कर. आगे अगर फिर से मिलेगा तो फिर से हम बताएं. Okay. Turn off your mic. Turn off your mic. Okay. Now accounting concepts. People not find the accounting concept as long question. Surely will get the short questions. Minimum 4 to 5 short questions will be asked in the examination in the last 2 months question. Next week, accounting concepts, business entity concepts. Let's check. have to watch the time also. Business entity concept. Business entity concept means simply just write down owner and its business. Owners and its business have separate identity. Business or business ke owner, वो separate हैं, एक नहीं. That means owner is also a person. Yes. Business is also a person. Yes. From the legal point of view, from the law point of view, business has also entity. Because you have established a business partnership firm, they know it. It has also identity, it has also registration, all these things. So business entity concept. Due to this concept, we can say if owner contributes capital to the business, then it is asset for the owner and liability for the business. Because the entity concept is there. Owner different from its business. They are two separate persons. Understand? नहीं तो आप बिजनेस कर भी नहीं सकते. इफ यू बिलोंग टू द मारवाड़ी फैमिली देन यू नो बिजनेस को अलग माना जाता है. मनी मेजरमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट सिंपली मीन्स आई विल बी सजेस्टिंग द डायरेक्ट हिट पॉइंट्स बट आई हैव अंडरस्टूड. मनी मेजरमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट सिंपली मीन्स द ट्रांजैक्शंस व्हिच कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड in the terms of money are recorded. Your transactions money ke term pe express ho sakte hain, wahi record ho sakte hain. Understand the points? Jab money ke term pe transaction nahi record nahi ho sakte hain, aur record hi nahi. For example, goods worth rupees 5000 lost is a monetary transaction. We can record the loss of 5000 and we can record the material shortage. The loss of the 5000. Suppose our manager died. Is our managing director died. This is a great loss for the business. Business might incur a loss of 1 crore rupees. Still you can't record. Because this is a social loss. This is loss for the human being obviously. But you can't record. Decision of death of managing director cannot be quantified in the terms of money. कितना loss हुआ exactly इसको quantify नहीं कर सकते हो. That's why it cannot be recorded. So all the social aspect and all these things cannot be recorded. Only the economical aspects can be recorded. Objective evidence concept. Understand the points. Later on I will come to this. All these things, these concept are applied for at the time of recording. इसको लिख At the time of recording, this concept are recorded. I'm saying this thing. Historical record concept, that means suppose we have purchased furniture at rupees 50,000 a month ago. Till we have to record this 50,000 rupees as book value at our That means historical record comes. आज की डेट में मार्केट में सपोज इसका वैल्यू है 60,000, तो कैन नॉट रिकॉर्ड 60,000. नेक्स्ट हिस्ट्रिकल कॉन्सेप्ट दैट मीन्स जो रेट में हम खरीदे थे उसी रिकॉर्ड में उसी रेट में फर्नीचर को लिखना पड़ेगा. कॉस्ट कॉन्सेप्ट अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट्स दैट मीन्स ये सिंपली इसी को ही जब फर्नीचर के हिसाब से चलो फर्नीचर can be recorded at cost, not at realizable value. Understand? That means ki humko jitna cost pada, development of a building, just look at this. Buildings banane mein, ek machine ko development karne mein, ek copyright ko banane mein, humko cost pada tha 1 lakh rupees. So you have to write the 1 lakh rupees as the cost. ये बिल्डिंग को बेचने में ये कॉपीराइट्स को बेचने में हमको मिलते 2 लाख रुपया यू कैनॉट रिकॉर्ड. कॉस्ट कॉन्सेप्ट मींस व्हिच कॉस्ट यू हैव इनकर्ड दैट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड. डुअल एस्पेक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट मींस फॉर एवरी ट्रांजैक्शन वी हैव डुअल एस्पेक्ट्स वन इज डेबिट अनदर इज क्रेडिट. अंडरस्टैंड टेक द प्रीवियस एग्जांपल हियर assets and liabilities. When we have invested cash, cash is debited, capital is credited. Next, when we have purchased furniture, furniture debited and cash is credited. Always for each and every transactions, debit credit concept are there. So I'm here just studying the dual concept are there. I'm not teaching you the journal and all these things. Dual concept is there. That means for each transaction, you have to record two accounts, and one account will always be debited, another will always be debited. Next, objective evidence concept. That means for each transactions, you must have supportive evidences also. Because later on, you have to face audit. Yes, you have together the vouchers, etc. That means कोई भी एक transaction of incur करते हो उसका written document, vouchers, debit note, credit note, deposit slip आपके पास होने चाहिए. Understand the point? Oral transactions cannot be recorded. This is the objective evidence transaction is recorded. These concepts are based on. Let me check. Finalizing the accounts. Finalizing the accounts. Recording के time पे ये concept use होते हैं. Finalizing of accounts के time पे ये use. Going concern concept का मतलब क्या होता है? Our business will go forever till doomsday. Go forever. It is not necessary to wind up. And it will not be shut down without by any external force. Going concern concept का मतलब होता है all the transactions are recorded by keeping in this mind. By keeping this mind, our business will go forever. It's not necessary to wind up in the near future. तो इसका मतलब क्या होता है? इसीलिए depreciation लगता है. Depreciation क्यों लगता है? क्योंकि it will not be wound up in the near future. Accounting period concept. Accounting period concept का मतलब होता है you have to finalize the accounts at a regular number one at a regular time interval. Regular time interval में आपको finalize करना होगा. In India it's 1 year. तो 1 year की एक पीरियड में हम अकाउंट्स को फाइनलाइज करते हैं. आवर बिजनेस पीरियड स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम अप्रैल 1st एंड एंड्स ऑन 31st मार्च. तो इन इंडिया अकाउंटिंग पीरियड का मतलब होता है यू हैव टू फाइनलाइज द अकाउंट्स इन एवरी 1 year एंड दिस फाइनेंस एंड दिस अकाउंटिंग पीरियड स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 1st अप्रैल and continues to 31st March. Next to it, matching concepts. What is meant by the matching concept? Look at. For 1 year period of accounting, if you take the revenues, for 1 year, you have to take the expenditure for 1 year also. If you are taking assets up to a certain date, 31st March, you have to take liabilities also up to the 31st March. This is what called the technical meaning of the matching concept. You might have read that the matching concept का मतलब हर एक debit, हर एक credit होता है, debit side यहाँ होता है, credit side वहाँ होता है, not like that. For the same period of time, you have to split the revenues and expenditure simultaneously for exact the same period or same time. एक साल के लिए अगर आप इनकम ले रहे हो तो एक साल के लिए आप एक्सपेंडिचर ले, एक साल तक आप एसेट ले रहे हो तो उसी एक साल तक आप ले रहे हो. This is what called the matching concept. ऐसा क्यों? Because you can get the exact profit of that period. Understand the point? हमको इसी एक साल का प्रॉफिट चाहिए, इसी एक साल का रेवेन्यू, इसी एक साल का एक्सपेंडिचर देंगे, तब यू विल गेट द प्रॉफिट ऑफ this particular year only. This is conservatism concept. Direct meaning में conservatism का concept होता है, मतलब होता है be conservative while recording the revenues. Revenue जब जब record कर रहे हो थोड़ा कंजूसी करो, सीधी बात है. Expenses and losses can be recorded as income. Expenses and losses को जल्दी record करो, लेकिन revenues को जल्दी record नहीं करो. आपका realization का संभावना है, आप realize कर सकते हो तो record करो, जितना कम हो सके उतना record करो. Conservatism concept का मतलब यही है. That means benefit क्या है? Because access depend upon the revenues. So if you will record the false revenues, revenues which cannot be realized, then you have to incur the more taxes. So expenditure and losses को जल्दी record करो, revenues को recognition करोगे देख करके. ये होता है conservatism concepts. Consistency concept. Same accounting methods are followed from year to year. Consistency का मतलब होता है accounting methods and concept must be followed from year to year. Consistently, that means the same methodology, same type of accounts, same trends of information are to be followed for the different periods. Take an example. If we will calculate the goodwill answer, if we will calculate the goodwill by purchase of years method in 2019, in 2020 also you have to calculate the goodwill by applying the purchase method. Same methodologies are followed from year to year. Full disclosure concept. In a company, nothing is private, everything is public. You have to disclose all those concepts which are relevant to the investor. Users of accounting information are putting government, bankers, investors, they need your accounting information because their personal judgment, their personal decision based on your financial statements. That's why you have to disclose all this financial information which might influence the decision. This is what called full disclosure concepts. Accounting हमको यही सलाह देता है कि आप you are practicing good, you are practicing bad, you are practicing legally, you are practicing illegally. Everything will be disclosed. Full disclosure means all this necessary information, all these necessary revenues must be disclosed before the public. Materiality concept, यहाँ पर थोड़ा देखेंगे. ये दो controversial है. Materiality concept क्या कहता है? The transactions having any relevant materiality, they are recorded. Suppose कुछ ट्रांजेक्शन से जिसका इरिलीवेंट गुड्स परचेस्ड 5,000. नाउ वी पेड द ऑटो फेयर ₹30, द लेबर चार्ज ₹10, समर आस्क्ड फॉर ₹5, टोल चार्जेस सपोज पेड ₹50, एवरीथिंग कैन बी सम अप इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड्स. So finally we can write by adding these things, suppose 30, 40, 50, 90, 95, 5,000, 95, anything. So directly we can write the purchase cost as 5,095 dirhams. effective of, besides all these small expenditures. That means जो expenditure, जो transaction उनके कोई relevance नहीं होते हैं उनको हम skip कर सकते हैं. Materiality concept यही कहता है. ये बात understand the point? इसका materiality है. कोई 5 रुपए का खर्चा हुआ किसी और expenditure में जोड़ दो, ये बात है. Materiality concept जिसका relevance है उसको record करो. हालांकि this is a broad concept. I just explain these things in the help of this. This is a broad concept. Accounting standards ऐसे शुरू होता है. So excuse me, the learners, just here I want to take a break. Can I do that?
Yes, sir.
Accounting concept covered. Accounting standards. Now down here. Now there are some basic standards. Set standards means here we can say the written principles. This ink is not visible. So basic principles and. You can say the methodologies, the theories, the concepts issued by authorized organizations, that is ICAI, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. ICAI not only institutes to educating, to graduating the CA students, ICAI also the financially and accounting advisory to the government of India. That's why ICAI issued some standards, okay, for error free presentation of the financial statements. The accounting standards are set by ICAI, okay, by the board ASB, accounting standard board. Here are some accounting standards. Not in your syllabus given in the detail, just you have to remember 5 to 6 or 10 standards for writing purpose. So it will be asked, may you will be asked the theory that what is accounting standard, and write down all the 5 accounting standards. So accounting standard 1 till date, accounting standards 27, in this much of accounting standards are there. These have said to accounting standards let down some principles, some norms, some methodologies, some ideas, some tricks by which you can comply here accounting with the Companies Act, with the norms of government, and you can comply the SEBI guidelines and can present your financial statements error. Likewise, one thing I will explain. One, disclosure of accounting policies. That means which policies, which methods you are adopting for preparation and presentation of your accounting statements, that must be disclosed before the public. Understand? The balance sheet hota hai, balance sheet ke niche ye aapko publish karna hota hai. Valuation of inventories, by which method apply you have to value the inventory, that means your stocks. So like this, these are some accounting standards which must be obey, comply while presenting and preparation of your financial statements. Okay, next we ask here unit 3, financial statements. It's interlinked to the financial accounting. Okay, to the financial accounting, that's why unit 3 will be discussed first. Unit 3 mein hum kya dekhenge, financial statements. Number 1, financial statements. So usko dekhenge introduction. Nature, which is the nature of financial statement, contents of financial statement, concept of capital and revenue recognition, okay, format of financial statements, corporate financial statements, schedule 6, basic principles and preparation. So introduction, financial statements ka matlab hi kya hota hai. Number 1, jata hum explain karenge jata likha nahi hai. Financial statements यहाँ पर येलो नहीं दिखता, statements prepared based on the accounting information for presentation to the users of accounting information are called the financial statements. Financial statement. Understand the points? Basically, financial statements means a trading account, P&L account, balance sheet. As the commerce background student, you may know. The financial statements, these are periodically summarized. Number one, prepared periodically, presented before the users of accounting information. Users of accounting information. Okay, and we'll discuss the balance sheet, profit loss account. For the company, financial statements are prepared as per the Schedule 6th of the Companies Act 1956. And for the other types of organizations, you are free to make your own financial statements, but by using the principle of accounting. For companies, you have to obey the Companies Act 2013. I'm very much sorry, ये आपकी book में लिखा हुआ था तो हम इसको आप उठा लें. I'm extremely sorry. Companies Act 2013 के हिसाब से आपको लिखना होगा. If anything अगर आपकी mind में अभी confusion नहीं हुआ, कि study material में Companies Act 1956 दिया हुआ है, और अभी जो prevailing Companies Act है, वो Companies Act 2013 है, तो हम क्या करें? Companies Act 2013 के हिसाब से काम करके Companies Act 1956 के हिसाब से काम करें. Listen, यहाँ पर examiner क्या करता है? So you can directly okay write down the principles of the financial statement as per the Companies Act 2013. That is very much correct. If you are writing the principles and the theories of the Companies Act 1956, just mention their things. Ki provided study material pe humko Companies Act 1956 ka data tha, usliye hum present kar rahe hain hamara answer usi hisab se. So here I am giving the answers as per the Companies Act 1956 because we are provided with this much of material. ये आपको नोट्स में आपको लिखना है. अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट. अगर अपडेटेड नोट्स है तो हम देखें, डाउनलोड कर भी सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट वीक देन अगर आपके पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म है या फिर सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप फॉर्म है, जस्ट बाय कंप्लाइंग द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द अकाउंटिंग यू कैन प्रिपेयर योर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. नो सच बार आर देयर. कंपनी अगर कंपनी होगा तो आपके हिसाब से बनाना होगा. अगर आपके सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप फॉर्म है तो आप खुद बना सकते हैं. यू आर फ्री बट अकाउंटिंग के प्रिंसिपल को मानकर. फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स के ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या होते हैं? टू मेक रैशनल इन्वेस्टमेंट क्रेडिट एंड सिमिलर अदर फाइनेंशियल डिसीजंस. नंबर वन, फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स हम बनाएंगे. फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स आगे दिखा देंगे क्या क्या फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट है. अंडरस्टैंड दिखा देते हैं एक बार. मैनुफैक्चरिंग अकाउंट, ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट एंड बैलेंस शीट. जनरली ये सबको फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट कहा जाता है. तो फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स के ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या होते हैं? टू मेक रैशनल इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, दैट मींस वी कैन अट्रैक्ट द इन्वेस्टमेंट्स फ्रॉम द आउटसाइडर्स बाय शोइंग देम द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट. फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स इज द मिरर ऑफ आवर कंपनी. This is the mirror of our company. By showing which we can attract the investors. Number two, और भी क्या हो सकते हैं? By watching the financial statements, we can know the profitable area, of our business. इस हिसाब से भी हम काम कर सकते हैं. तो financial statements investment करने के लिए काम आते हैं. Next is make credit similar other financial decisions. फाइनेंशियल डिसीजन इन्वेस्टमेंट करेगी नहीं. क्रेडिट बैंक में अलाउ यू द लोन बाय वॉचिंग योर फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट इज द डायरेक्ट. अदर सिमिलर फाइनेंशियल डिसीजन, एवरी डिसीजन आर टेकन बाय द मैनेजर्स बाय द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स बाय वॉचिंग द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑल बिकॉज फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट डिस्क्लोज ऑल दिस फाइनेंशियली रिलेवेंट इंफॉर्मेशन विच मेक द डिसीजन मेकर understand the business. That's why financial decision के लिए आपको ये चाहिए. To estimate future cash flow and bankruptcy risk assessment is a technical point. future cash flow, yes. By watching the sales trend, by watching the sales trend, by watching the profit trend from the financial position, you can easily assume, ascertain the future cash flow of the business. Bankruptcy risk assessment. Bankruptcy का मतलब होता है आपकी insolvency का chances. Insolvency का chances means financial position. आपकी company में financial position आगे जा करके upward रहेगा कि downward रहेगा. These can be ascertained by the financial statement because financial statements में क्या होता है? Assets होते हैं, liabilities होते हैं. Assets liabilities की trend को देख करके आप बता सकते हो कि आगे जा करके आपकी पोजीशन फाइनेंशियल पोजीशन क्या है. टू आसर्टेन द नेट एसेट वैल्यू और नेट वर्थ ऑफ द एंटरप्राइज आफ्टर दिस इज वेरी मच क्रूशियल बिकॉज़ इन्वेस्टर्स विल इन्वेस्ट ऑन योर कंपनी ऑन योर एसेट्स ऑन योर बिजनेस बाय वाचिंग द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स सो दे क्वाइट हैव इंटरेस्ट टू नो द नेट वर्थ ऑफ द कंपनी. नेट वर्थ ऑफ द कंपनी मींस द नेट वैल्यू ऑफ द कंपनी. Aggregation of all the shares value is known as the net worth of the company. Evaluating the value of the assets, resources, owned claims, there are the net worth case evaluation hota hai, value of the assets, resources, owned and the liabilities. Aapke paas kya hai? Isse pe lage. In order to make share purchase, sales decision, takeover, merger decisions, the company are important decisions, financial statements ko dekh kar ki hi lete hai. Understand the points? तो यूनिट टू में आपका ये इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन हो गया. यूनिट टू में इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ये हो गया. लिख लीजिए अगर कोई भी सवाल यूनिट टू से आते हैं तो यही है. व्हिच आर द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स क्वेश्चन मार्क नंबर टू. व्हाट आर इट्स elements which are the financial statements what are its elements what are its objectives note down it. So financial statement kya hota hai iske elements kya hote hain.
Excuse me sir, what is the third question?
This is a single question, understand the point, write down.
Okay
ha
please tell me once again.
Yeah, write down please. Which are the financial statements? What are its objectives? Are you understood? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
What are its elements? What are its elements? Okay, note it down.
Yes, sir.
नेक्स्ट ताकि देखिए तो फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट डिसीजन में कैसे काम आते हैं. बाय वाचिंग द फाइनेंशियल पोजीशन बाय वाचिंग द प्रॉफिट ट्रेंड कंपनी डिसीजन क्या लेता है टू सेल सेल इन ऑर्डर टू मेक शेयर परचेज सेल डिसीजन. अब शेयर परचेज या सेल करोगे सीधी बात होता है अनदर बिजनेस टेक ओवर या सेल करोगे खुद की बिजनेस takeover and merger decision. That means another company acquire करोगे या फिर आप खुद merge हो जाओगे किसी और company में. All these decisions are based on the financial statements. Simple thing is that this is the mirror, this is the showcase of the company. So financial statement को देख करके सब कुछ because which affairs are going inside the company are irrelevant to the public, are relevant to the researchers, scholars. Simply they need the summarized financial information. Collective branding decision relating to wages, working condition and job security. You can see that means decisions relating to wages, working condition, job security. These are also known from the financial statement. अच्छी financial statement होंगे तो wages, working condition और job security उस company में अच्छे रहे. To make assessment of economic and financial decisions, for make assessment of economic and financial decisions, First, you can take the decisions based on the financial statements. Next to it, which decisions you have taken, economic and financial decisions. As I have stated from the very beginning, in financial accounting, only the economic and financial decisions are taken, not the social decisions. उसके लिए कुछ अलग accounting है, social accounting भी है. The economic and financial decisions which you have taken can be assessed also. Understand, that means whether improvement is necessary, whether you have to control on these decisions, whether we have to drop a particular decision, whether you have to extend another decisions. So assessment can also be done to form appropriate taxation and subsidy policy, regular policy and employment policy. Taxation policy is very much crucial because you have to save tax also. Subsidy policy and employment policy. Good is the profit trend, higher is the employment chance, possibility. Taxation के ऊपर क्या डिपेंड होता है? Tax planning can also be done. You might have read this thing. Corporate tax planning can also be done by watching the financial statements. The financial statement not only disclose the profitability and financial position of the company, but also it helps in various ways for saving tax also, for employment purpose also, for investment purpose also, for attracting customers also, for demerger amalgamation also, all this. Now, which are the financial statements? As I stated, manufacturing account number 1, trading account number 2, profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account, and balance sheet. Well, it's some meaning you have to know, then to the formats. I am thinking कि पहले फॉर्मेट बताया जाए. Okay, we'll discuss it later. Because format of this we have to know concept of capital and revenue. Concept of capital and return. So we will find. At the same time, I suggest the questions also. Will find the questions appearing for marks. Yeah. It means between.
Sir, please repeat once again from starting.
हम तो question ही पता है नहीं आपको. And
sir, your voice is breaking. I mean, it's not clear.
Yes, sir, you are not audible. Your voice is breaking.
Please let me know. Now am I audible?
You are audible.
Another one, another audience. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because all these things are technical, isn't it? Not in my hand. That's why. अब भर्ती स्पीड नहीं चलेगा तो हम क्या करेंगे?
Yes sir.
Sorry for that. For marks, distinguish between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Number 2, distinguish between. Presentation दिख रहा था? Is it visible? Visible my presentation?
Yes sir. So distinguish between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure.
And revenue expenditure. Next, distinguish between capital receipts and revenue receipts. रेवेन्यू रिसीप्ट, क्या बात है? कैपिटल रिसीप्ट, रेवेन्यू रिसीप्ट, कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर, रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर। समटाइम इंटरनेट गो स्लो डाउन, प्रॉब्लम होता है।
सर, सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस कंटेंट्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स? नो,
Yes, I didn't get it. What you said?
Sir, have we already discussed the contents of financial statements?
No. Contents of financial statements not yet discussed. Okay. Not yet discussed. Now look at first concept of capital and revenue. I already told that. I will show you. This is the thing. Format of financial statement, contents of financial statement. This will be discussed later. Before it, you have to understand this. Concept of कैपिटल एंड रेवेन्यू, इसमें कैपिटल रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर, कैपिटल रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर, कैपिटल एंड रेवेन्यू रिसीप्ट्स, ये तीन थिंग्स के। तो एक बार देख लीजिए ध्यान से। फर्स्ट रिटर्न, कैपिटल एंड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स, कैपिटल एंड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स हम लिख देते हैं। कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर्स, रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स, इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग। Capital expenditure means, number one, I'm starting that term. Let me change the pink color. Permanent in nature. Permanent in nature. Capital. Here revenue expenditure. Temporary in nature. Temporary in nature. That means, for example, capital expenditure. Purchase of assets, plant and building, etc. ये होता है purchase of assets whose benefit will be received over a long period of time. Purchase of asset is also expenditure. Next week, payment of salary. Payment of salary. By watching the time constraints.
Excuse me, sir. Please repeat second point once again.
Okay. First is capital expenditure के नीचे आप देखो. Permanent in nature, below to the revenue expenditure, I have written temporary in nature. Second point, यहाँ पर लिखे purchase of assets, यहाँ payment of salary. Look at what is the difference.
Sorry sir, once again please repeat this point.
Purchase of asset, payment of salary. Listen, purchase of asset is also expenditure. Payment of salary is also expenditure. But assets, hum ek bar khareed li, purchase of assets. Understand the point. Suppose this one is the asset. Benefit of this assets will be derived over a long period of time. This works as the capital investment in my business. Because once I have purchased the land and building, the benefit of the land and building will be derived over the lifetime of my business. Hence, it works as the capital. That's why such expenditure is known as the capital expenditure. It's the direct meaning of this. So many indirect meanings and definitions are written in the books. Expenditure which works as the capital investment. This is what called the capital expenditure, like purchase of the assets. Next week, this is payment of salary. Salary, once I have paid in this month, again I have to pay the same to the same person, the same salary in the next month, and will be continued on this. That means benefit of payment of salary to my business is temporary. This will be paid in a regular time interval. Hence, it is revenue expense. That means it burst as it worked as, or it gives benefit to earning the revenue. That's why it is revenue expenditure. So expenditure capital ke hisab se kaam karte hain, capital investment ki tarah hamare business pe kaam karate hain, wo capital expenditure hote hain. Jo expenditure revenue earn karne ke liye hote hain, wo revenue expenditure hote hain. Inka benefit permanent hai, inka benefit temporary. So hum jaldi points ko cover karenge, agar aap likh sakte ho to likhoge, nahi to bas just likh sakte. Next week, This is in huge amount. Capital expenditure generally huge amount. This is in small amount. The revenue expenditure small amount. Understand the point? Because purchase of assets generally that incurs huge amount, lakhs of rupees. Salary may be in thousands of rupees. Okay. Next week. ये वंस ऑकर होते हैं ऑकर वंस ये ऑकर रेगुलर रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर रेगुलरली ऑकर जैसे कि परचेज ऑफ बिल्डिंग
तब कुछ सर कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर इज
इरेगुलर इन नेचर दैट यू कैन से नॉन रेक्यूरिंग दैट यू कैन से द नॉन रेक्यूरिंग दिस इज recurring intentionally I am not using the that means ki accounting languages and commercial languages because that I do understood to all that side the non recurring and this is recurring this is irregular this is regular in nature next week okay capital expenditures are expend for growth and development of the business growth and development of the business अरे मैं आप प्लॉट खरीदते हो सपोज दिस इज फॉर ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ योर फैमिली अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट नेक्स्ट रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स आर सिंपली मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द डे टू डे बिजनेस इज द थिंग मेंटेनेंस ऑफ डे टू डे बिजनेस अगेन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड पेमेंट ऑफ सैलरी Suppose repairs of the machines, all these things can only maintain your business. That will not grow your business. But purchase of the land, buildings, assets, shares of another company, that will grow and develop your business. Understand the point? This is your next week. Just the important point. Okay. I'm making it clear. यहाँ पर था कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर यहाँ पर था रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर्स आर नोन एज द एसेट्स रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर्स आर रिगार्डेड एज द एक्सपेंडिचर्स दिस इज यू कैन ए कॉमन मैन कैन ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड
एक्सक्यूज मी सर सर प्लीज रिपीट दिस पॉइंट वंस अगेन
कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर जस्ट नोट डाउन एसेट्स revenue expenditure just not down expenditures that's difference between expenses and expenditures there is a technical point for the time being think that these are the same capital expenditure assets maana dete for like purchase of buildings abhi to bataya from purchase of buildings this is also expenditure purchase of car purchase of plots this is also expenditure but you know buildings plot car all these are assets but revenue expenditures are regarded as the expenditure suppose repairs wages payment of salary all these things are expenditures this is the difference next capital expenditure are assets hence they are shown on the asset side of balance sheet I'll repeat it just keep listening capital expenditures are asset hence shown on asset side of balance revenue expenditures are expenditures hence debit side of trading or PL account debit side of trading or
sir PL. Can you please repeat this particular last point that capital expenditures are asset side
these all are first I have to take understood I understood just one of them understood All these are the technical points. If you are getting, then okay. If you are not getting, then will be discussed later. Capital expenditures are the assets because motor car plots are the assets. So these are shown in the asset side of balance sheet. Just write down asset side of balance. Go to the right side. Go to the right side. Revenue expenditures are the expenses. Hence, these are shown. Debit side of trading and PL account. बिकॉज ट्रेडिंग एंड पीएल अकाउंट में एक्सपेंडिचर्स एंड इनकम्स रिकॉर्ड होते हैं, क्योंकि वो एक्सपेंडिचर है वो डेबिट साइड आते हैं, कौन डेबिट साइड क्रेडिट साइड फॉर्मेट लास्ट में डिस्कस है, दिस इज द कांसेप्ट. सो आई हैव टाइम कम्स इन फ्रंट, दैट्स इट, आई वांट टू गो नेक्स्ट, अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट्स, आई एम जस्ट इरेजिंग दिस. Next page. So capital and revenue expenditure are there. Some are deferred revenue expenditure. So this is a short question. Deferred revenue expenditures. That means some expenditures are capital expenditures, some are the revenue expenditure. But some expenditure are there which are deferred revenue expenditures. That means these expenditure works as neither capital nor revenue expenditure. These have the features of both. Features of
sir,
both.
Please repeat this point once again.
Revenue. Okay. Deferred revenue expenditure means हम सीधा बताते हैं. हमेशा deferred का मित्र मतलब आप समझ जाओ. Deferred का मतलब होता है to some extent खिंचाई लंबाई. To some extent it has also feature of capital expenditure. It has also feature of revenue expenditure. The features having both the capital and revenue expenditure is called the deferred revenue expenditure. For example, advertising expenditure. Applicable example, heavy advertising expenditure. I am giving you the example. Heavy advertising expenditure. Very much practical. For the Ching's noodle. Suppose for the Ching's noodle. As you have seen the advertisement of the Ranveer Singh. Advertisement was made like the movie, etc. Okay, understand the point. This incurs heavy expenditure. Ranveer Singh charged 80 crores to 100 crore for signing this. Documents only for signing this advertisement paper only. Okay, around they spent 150 crore rupees on this advertisement. But the influence, the benefit of this advertisement derived over a long period of time. That means, ये जो advertisement expenditure था, इसका benefit 1 year में खत्म नहीं हुआ. The benefit was not last in a single year. It extended to some years, say 5 years. Still people remember that advertisement, the effect of that advertisement. That means if the benefit will be the temporary, that will be revenue. If the benefit will be the permanent, that will be capital. But advertisement expenditure in this case extended to some years and will be last. That's why this is called the deferred revenue expenditures. It's neither revenue neither capital. So listen, one thing, the expenditure whose benefit is extended to few accounting period. Note that. Extended to few accounting period. It's called deferred revenue expenditure. Another example, preliminary expenses. Understand the point? So preliminary expenses means when you are setting up a company. Suppose this is company. Excuse me. Suppose you are setting up a company. First, you have to advertise for this, register for this. You have to expense the brokerage charges. You have to so many. TA charges are there. Legal charges are there. So many charges are there. Registration fees there. Suppose you incur 1 crore rupees on this. 1 crore rupees, maan liye nahi hoga, 10 lakhs rupees on these things. Now this 10 lakhs rupees registration charges of this company, the benefit will be derived over a long period of time. Hence, this is the expenditure. Preliminary expenses of the company's expenditure, but the benefit of which goes for a long period of time. That's why this is deferred revenue expenditure. Neither capital nor revenue. If it will be permanent for the entire life, that is be capital. If it is restricted to a certain period, that will be revenue. Next. Here, this is deferred capital. Likewise, capital and revenue receipts. Capital and revenue receipts. ये क्या होता है? Write down here. Capital receipts. Write down here. Revenue receipts. Now look at likewise capital and revenue receipt. Suppose you have received a government grant for building. Suppose you have received interest from bank. These are two receipts. Government grants you have received for building and revenue receipts, interest from bank. Both are the receipts. No problem at all. But listen one. Government grant received for the buildings is permanent in nature. Is permanent in nature. And interest from bank, this is temporary interest. This is temporary interest. This is irregular. Government, once you have received the grant from the government, you can expect it will be received on a regular basis. Because building ek baar banane ke liye aapko government se milegi. Regularly nahi milegi. But interest banks sabko mile hai, this will be regular. At a regular time interval, you will get this. Now, capital receipts is regarded as liability. I'm explaining. Revenue receipt regarded as income. Are you listening? Just reply one.
Sir, please yes, repeat sir. This point once again.
Yes. All these things which I am studying are not in the books. You can't get anywhere else. These are the technical points. Understand the point? And you have directly write these points to get the full marks. Nothing else. Now today's age, today's era, you need not to elaborate the theory. Number one, receipts are of two types. May be permanent, may be temporary. From the beginning, I'm saying government grant for building, right side, interest from bank. Left side, permanent, right side, temporary. Left side, irregular, right side, regular. Left side is liability, right side is income. Why is it so? I am saying. Now, government grants in permanent nature, you understand? And these are received irregular. But
sir,
I am
not able to understand this thing. Can you like, please?
Yes, sir. Please repeat this point once again. I am also not understanding this.
Okay. Now you got the point, government grants from the building. That means government allows you grants. Suppose you have a non-profit organization. Understand?
Yes, sir. Government, it grants building and then for the capital receipts and for the revenue receipts. Like, that I don't understand what... Government grants building of that I understand, but other than that, I am not getting the point. Hello? Hello?
Sir, you are not audible. Your voice is breaking. Hello.
I think sir has left. Sir is not there. Did you get the concept of capital and reverse visit?
Actually, there are two types of expenditure.
Capital receipt is regular or irregular?
I'm telling you, first we talk about capital expenditures, right? Capital expenditures like we purchase plant and machinery, land, matlab, these are the biggest expenditures for a business. And the benefits are derived in not only in 1 year, but in n number of years, means 5 to 10 years at least. So those expenditures are capital expenditures. Like, and there are revenue. Like operating expenditures, like salary.
I'm not wages. Able to understand. Please.
Okay. I just read that. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Am I audible? Am I audible?
Now I am audible.
Yes, actually my internet was interrupted. Okay.
Hello.
Sir, am I audible?
Now you are audible.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Madam.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In 2 minutes, I'm explaining. Obviously, this is my responsibility. This is my liability to make you understand. Okay. No problem at all. Okay.
So we can't say it's a liability, sir.
Just single taking. Yes, we are. Look at what I was saying. Capital receipts and revenue receipts. So here was the example, government grants is also received, and interest from bank is also received. Is it visible to you? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, government grants and interest from banks. Government grant, now, itna bhi aap samajh sakte ho, this is permanent in nature. This is temporary in nature. This is irregular in nature. You obviously understand. This is irregular in nature. This is regular in nature. And this is government, the capital receipts. Okay? Received for erection of building. Suppose erection of the buildings. Now these become our liability. But interest from bank, this become our income. I will be explaining, no problem. The capital receipts or revenue receipts with generally different scale. So receipts for the growth and development of the organization. Just write down growth and development of the organization. Revenue receipts kya hota? for maintenance of daily expenditures. That means expenditures are there for which we just cannot be maintain our daily business. We can compensate our daily expenditures. Such expenditures are known as the such receipts are known as the revenue receipt. Both are the same thing. This is from receipt point of view, these are from expenditure point of view. So for which receipt we can compensate our expenditures on daily basis, these are called the revenue receipt. For example, you can understand interest from banks, sales, okay, commissions, if we received some commissions, etc. That means interest, sales revenue, commissions, for these incomes, for these revenues, we can maintain our daily expenditures. And this is, these are sales, commissions, all these things on regular basis. These are temporary incomes. Hence, these are called the revenue receipt. Simply means receipts which works as revenue, which are on daily basis, which generates our revenues, our incomes. Revenue simply means these are called the revenue receipts. But listen one thing. Government grants, we have received 1 crore. Government grant received 1 crore, which cannot be expensed for any other purpose. You can make a feast by using this 1 crore fund. You cannot arrange your own marriage ceremony by using this 1 crore rupees. It's liability to build the building. That means capital receipt, irregular in nature, permanent in nature, which must be utilized for the growth and development for the of the business. Hence, technically, capital receipts milne se hum unko liability kehte. Capital receipts milne se hum unko liabilities kehte. These cannot be said as profits. Ye profit ke hisab se, revenue ke hisab se count nahi. That's why capital receipts liability ke tarah chalta. The revenue receipts mein kya hota hai, regular in nature, this is regarded as the revenues or incomes. Yahi tak baat tha, aur kuch understand? Aur bhi koi aap bata sakte hain? Fund receipt, capital receipt mein kya hota, fund receipt, buildings receipt, asset contributed, understand? Loan taken, capital receipt mein aur kya ho sakte hain? Loans taken, this is also the capital receipts. These all are the liabilities for the company. But revenue received are the income. Now go to the technical part. Capital receipts are as liabilities recorded, right? Capital receipts are as liabilities recorded on the liability side of balance sheet. This is important, right? Liability side of balance sheet. Revenue receipts are income. These are incomes. Hence, recorded on the credit side of rating or profit and loss account. Trading or profit
sir,
and loss.
Sir, please repeat both the points.
Okay. As you know, capital receipts are the liability. Hence, at which place these are shown? Liability side of the balance. Liability side of the balance. Right side, revenue receipts are the income. Hence, these are recorded credit side of trading and PL. Just repeat one thing. Do you get or not? Understood or not? Just time.
Yes, sir.
बस यही तक बात है बिकॉज परमानेंट इन नेचर तो लाइबिलिटी होने क्योंकि वी आर लाइबल टू यूज दैट फंड इन अ प्रॉपर वे आफ्टर बिल्डिंग डायरेक्ट एटसेट्रा लाइबिलिटी होते हैं बिकॉज दे वर्क एज द कैपिटल एंड यू नो कैपिटल इज द लाइबिलिटी जो रेवेन्यू कैपिटल की तरह काम करेंगे कैपिटल लाइबिलिटी होता है तो वो रेवेन्यू भी लाइबिलिटी हो जो रेवेन्यू इनकम्स की तरह काम करते हैं तो इनकम है तो इनकम साइड हम दिखाएंगे दिस इज द थिंग तो होप यू अंडरस्टैंड ओके
यस सर
आज के लिए इतना रहने देते हैं थैंक्स अ लॉट ओके तो समान पीरियड में इंफॉर्मेशन से इतना पे जिस दिल पर मात्र असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कोमोस मेरा कांटेक्ट नंबर यू कैन टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट दिस इज माय ईमेल
टुमारो विल बी टुमारो इज अ क्लास और नॉट
obviously, yes, tomorrow is the class, and if nothing will be mentioned, then at this time I will meet you. If time variation will be there, you will be intimated at time before. Okay.